dia?
Doncs estem a divendres, dia... Quin dia és?
31.
31 de gener. Queden res, dos dies, crec.
Really interesting shot here. We've got Tim there, that is walking from here to here. Olivia's hands here. And because it's a close-up, the scale is bigger with the mobile phone. Some tracking marks for the post-production. Those hands, they have a winder in its hand, so I can raise up and down its hand separately. I can animate its finger as well, and I can move every vices in all directions and both together with this table. That way I can animate Olivia in all the axes possible. And in order to keep track of all that, I've got one dragon frame here that controls everything together. But to see this fit all right, because in here they are super blurry, I've got a second dragon frame here, shooting from here with another camera, and that way I can see the legs in a more close up. And yeah, every frame I shoot both cameras, and I keep track of Tim, the hands, and the phone. This first video, that is awesome, was shot by Tim Allen, so I've got the reference there. And I just have to copy these legs here in here, so I can avoid animating all the body and hands, eyes, everything, just the legs. Hi everyone, it's Edu Puertas from Kinetic Armatures, and I'm super happy to finally show you all our improvements on the winders. This little device that I love so much because they help a lot when animating straight lines in your animations. It's a really helpful tool because you can move in a really tiny increments, that it's a lot more difficult to do with rig arms or normal rigs. So yeah, it's been a long journey since the day that we created the company Cytoplasmas with Irene back in 2008. We started selling things with Kinetic Armatures in 2011. It's a long time now, and we now have a team that helps me and makes incredible things, so super happy about that. Also happy about all the cool equipment that we have nowadays that allow us to make a lot better parts than when I started, and it has changed completely the way I design the parts and the way we machine and our standards of precision, and we are more exquisite now. that's probably the best stop motion animators tool. It's a tool or a device that it's called Winder, and it's used to animate things or to move things along an axis, describing always straight lines. It's really easy to use and it speeds up a lot the process of animating, because you have full control of the movement that you are making, and you can go back and forth and control exactly what you need. Inside of the device there is a gear, and when you turn the wheel, the gear spins, so it picks the teeth of the rack and it moves along. You can control very precisely very tiny amounts of movement or big movement, so it's really fast to use and precise at the same time. And you have two kind of controls. You can loosen or tighten these two nylon screws that will add friction to the rack, so you can either block or loosen the rack, so you have to apply less or more pressure to animate it. Or you have two screws more here that what will do is to apply more pressure underneath the rack. I decided to create three models, and having two versions on each model, that will be how many axes you can control with them. So the first one, it's the mini one. It's the one you have seen. It's really tiny and light. I like it a lot because you can animate it with this in the set, and it's really small. It's precise. The second one, it's the pro version of this one. It's the same thing, but this one, the rack is made of stainless steel, so it's much stronger and harder. And this is 10 by 10 millimeters, so it's almost the double size, so it's a lot more stronger, and it can hold a lot more weight on it. And the third one is the most affordable one. I designed it thinking into some budgets, mine included when I started, that cannot afford those. So in this one, I reduced as maximum the machining time, and this part is made of Delrin, so it's called Delrin. It's a kind of plastic, and it's mainly the same as those, simply that the machining time on this is smaller, so the cost is lower. And the rack, it's a lot cheaper because the teeth is bigger. It's less precise because the gear and the teeth on this, it's bigger, but you have the same amount of control. You can also have more complex winders like this one, that it's a system, and you can control not only one axis like this, but also vertical and front and back here. So with this kind of device, you can control in the space whatever you want in a very precise manner. This setup with three axes is in fact a Winder Pro with two axes, X and Y, plus a mini winder here with one axis. This could be a pro winder as well with one axis. Something really common would be to need to rig your puppet from the top using a scene stand or something similar. So something that I find super interesting and useful would be to mount your winder on a scene stand and then rig it to your puppet. So that way, instead of having this whole thing inside the set, you just have this rig coming from the top, and you can hang your puppet from the ceiling and control the up and down of your puppet by adjusting the winder here. This setup here is a little bit overkill, but yeah, it's the best way I have to show you exactly how the mini winder and the pro version will perform, because both have the same rack teeth, so the movement will be more or less the same. So this thing here is a dial indicator. It's used in CNC machining or in manual machining to indicate things. So when you want to measure your movement, it's the best tool you have. So every time the needle turns one turn, it's 1 millimeter. So if you want to move fast, you can do it. Every turn, 1 millimeter. Now let's try to be precise. I will place the needle in zero. Slowly. Okay. Now we are going to try to make exactly one turn. Let's say 1 millimeter. So slowly we are turning. And when we are near, we are going to slow down a bit more. And yeah, there you have it. That's 1 millimeter. If you have to readjust, you can do it trying to be super careful. I will go to 10 now. So we are in 10. Look how crazy this 10 means exactly 2 times one of my hair. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you want one of those, visit our website, kineticarmatures.com. You will find all the information there. If you have extra questions, mail us. We will try to help you. And if you are really interested to get one, make the order now, because I may take some time to make the second batch, because it takes a lot of time to make all the parts, and we basically invested 2 months to make this first batch. So yeah, I wish you a great 2021, and I also hope to be more often here in YouTube. It's super hard to do all the stuff I do and keep making videos, but yeah, I hope to be more often. I have some plans, wish them work, and see you soon. Take care, bye.